Hello everybody, welcome back to a new video, it's Gina here, and for today's Inktober I have an alien. Yeah, like, I will be honest with you guys, actually I wanted to do something different, like, all night, really, like, almost all night I was thinking, like, what should I do tomorrow, and, sorry for my voice, what should I do tomorrow, and I was thinking, and I was just so tired, and even this morning I was like, I think I will be drawing a forest, but I had an idea, and it isn't even that bad, but at the same time, I just felt like it would be, compared to yesterday's, really like, boring. Just boring, like, that is the best to explain it, I think. And I was looking at my prompt list that has different prompts from different prompt lists that I found on the internet, so I can have this idea simpler coming to me, I could say. And as I was looking at Alien, I just had an idea. I really had this idea. I did use different references, like not really, I looked at some pictures so that I kind of knew already that I wanted a big head, big eyes and everything, but I wanted a bit to, like, you know, more examples so it would look, I can't say natural, like it's an alien, but you know, the universe is big, so who knows, maybe they exist, maybe not, we will know, maybe someday, but yeah, I had this idea with the alien, and I was like really just taking my sketchbook, sketching in the thumbnail, and I was just like, okay, this is good, this will be it, and it's not always like this simple, like sometimes I have to do two or three thumbnails, and then the sketch won't turn out right and everything. I'm even thinking about doing a sketchbook tour after Inktober, because I don't have only the Inktober drawings in it, I also have, I believe, two sketches in it that I started, because the thumbnail was okay, but the sketch just didn't turn out the way. One I just read it, and on the other one I just let the idea be and did something different and new, because it just wouldn't turn out good, and I felt like a bad art day. Like, you know, you have those days where whatever you do, you feel like it's terrible and it won't turn out because this or that looks terrible for you, or it just really is terrible. And if you're interested, just tell me in the comments, do you want to see a sketchbook tour? Like, you know, not everyone has the time to watch every single Inktober drawing. Like, I myself, I'm almost 1 week behind with my subscribed videos, I could say. Like, my subscriber box that I watch all the YouTubers is 1 week behind because of Inktober. I just don't get to watch all them. I will slowly, and probably if I take 2 or 3 days of, like, not doing any videos or drawings, I will get there and watch everything. But I think I will do the little sketchbook tour because, as I say, some people just can't watch them all, and so they will see all the videos, like not the videos but the drawings. And also, if you watch my Inktobers, you can see the sketches that just didn't turn out quite good, and I just let it stay in there because, you know, I used a colored pencil lead, I could say, and you can't erase it so much that you can start over completely. But I think that's a good. If I do Inktober next year, I will definitely be using some different sketchbook, like a watercolor sketchbook or mixed media, because this paper really, like, warps. It's like really like wavy and everything. At some point I like it, like you look at the sketchbook and it's just beautiful, but at the other way it's just like you want the surface to be like, not a surface, but like you do a background. and it just won't turn out flat because the paper is like moving around, and you're just like, damn, why did I use a simple sketchbook? But at the same time, I love it. It's like really a love-hate relationship with all this Inktober. At one point, I love doing this, and at the other point, I'm just so exhausted that I really want to stop and want this to be over already. And so I'm really torn between these two things. And I think each of you that do Inktober every day kind of feel the same way, because it's like really satisfying, and at the same time it's so exhausting, and like doing the videos too and uploading all the social media sites that you're in is just crazy. And yeah, I'm probably crazy doing this, and I respect all the artists that do so much little details in their work. Like, I'm just like, my Inktobers do look like really simple when I look at others, like positively Vika, I believe. I'm sorry if I said your name wrong, girl, because I adore your Inktober videos. Like, she's so amazing how much detail she puts in them, and I'm just like, how? I'm happy if I can make something that looks kind of good in a way. She does like this super really I'm just speechless, to be honest. Like, sometimes she's like, yeah, this was pretty simple, and I think, simple, yeah, okay, maybe I shouldn't show my Inktobers. And this is getting pretty long, so I'm just shut up. And if you like this video, give a thumbs up. If you want to see the other Inktober videos and want to see what will be coming after Inktober, please give a subscribe. I would like to hear in the comments what you think about this all, and if you're still going at Inktober. Not much, guys, we can do it. And I will see you in the next video. Bye bye!